Here's Johnny.
But what I do have are very particular set of skills. Go ahead, make my day.
Yeah.
Keep the change, you filthy animal.
I love the smell of napalm in the morning.
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration?
And like that, he's gone. I get a lot of questions about lighting films. I think most people tend to overcomplicate this, so I've broken it down into a few simple steps. Note that the order of the steps is as important as the actual steps themselves. Here it is, the Guerrilla Film School 5-step film lighting plan. 1. Set your scene with no actors, and then set your camera's exposure, or ISO, to a level that properly exposes the main part of the shot for the lens and f-stop you're shooting the scene at. You can use a light meter or your camera's built-in light meter to set the levels. After you have some experience doing this, you'll be able to do it without using a meter at all. Step 2, set your main light, the key, to a level that properly exposes the actor at your current camera ISO. Step 3. Now you can adjust the ratio between the key light and the background to suit your taste and or the mood of the lighting. For example, if you want to make the actors pop out just a bit from the background, you can raise the level of your key light slightly so the light on the actors is more powerful. This will slightly overexpose the actors, so to compensate, you'll need to adjust your camera's ISO to a lower number, making the sensor less sensitive to light, to properly expose the actors. This will in turn make the background slightly darker. So for example, let's say you followed the first two steps and your background and actor under the key light are both properly exposed and your camera's ISO is currently set to 1200. You're going to increase the level of the key light, overexposing your actor, but the rest of the scene that's not under the key light will still be properly exposed. You want to make sure that your actor is exposed correctly, so you're going to lower the number of your camera's ISO to, say, 800. This makes the camera sensor less sensitive to light. Now, if you want to be exact, you'd put a light meter in front of the actor's face and set your camera's ISO to the level that the meter told you. But you can also just make these adjustments using your camera's meter or by eye. The important thing is that you are resetting the ISO to a level that properly exposes the actor. This, in turn, makes the background darker. Step 4. Set your fill lights to light any areas of the actor or parts of the scene that may be in shadows from the key light or other natural or practical lighting sources. The fill light should be set to a level that is less powerful than the key light, so your lighting has some dimension to it. How high that level is depends on how dramatic you want the lighting to be. If you're going for a striking, shadowy look, then keep the fill light level low. If you want a clean look with no shadows, then you'll want a higher level, but never as high as the key light. If you're unsure, it's always better to err on the side of slightly higher fill levels. You can always play with the levels in post-production if you want a more dramatic look, but if you keep your fill light too low and find that you need to boost the levels in post to get rid of shadows, you'll end up doing a lot more work and usually end up with a lot of noise. Step 5, set any accent lights. These might be a rim light on the back of the actor's shoulders and head to help separate them from the background, or you might want to draw attention to a certain area in the scene by having it slightly more lit. The important thing is that you do not change your camera's settings for these. Adjust the accent lights around your current setup. The level of the accent lights depends on what sort of effect you're going for. Again, it's best to err on the side of keeping things only slightly brighter than the rest of the scene. It's easy to increase the highlights of a scene in post to make these accent lights pop out, but if you overexpose them in production, you'll always have that ugly bright white spot. So there it is. This plan will work in practically any sort of situation. No matter what sort of lights or modifiers you're using, the process will always be the same. As I said before, sequence is super important here. Many people do this backwards and try to expose for accent lights, and then they end up getting a scene that has shadows, bright spots, and scenes that are both under and overexposed at the same time. Now, I know some of you will have questions about this. If you do, feel free to email me at brian@gorillafilmschool.com. And I will do my best to help you out.
Remember, if you want to learn how to make better films and act on camera, Gorilla Film School has got you covered. We put together a free training video on how directors and actors can work together on set. You can get instant access to this free training right now by going to gorillafilmschool.com/training.
He's gone.